Welcome to Chand Bagh School. Lecture 2, Grade 9, Physics, Code 5054. Section 1, General Physics. In general physics, our first unit is physical quantities and units and their measurements. During this unit, we will study about the physical quantities, units, scalar and vector quantities, measurement techniques of different instruments, and the symbols and the units which are used to show these physical quantities. In our first lecture, we have already discussed about the physical quantities and units. Dear students, in first lecture we have studied about the physical quantities. The physical quantities are those quantities which we can measure, and the physical quantities shows by the units. Now in this lecture we are discussed that there are two types of the physical quantities. So we can say that physical quantities can divide it into two groups. The first group of the physical quantity is scalar quantities, and the second group of the physical quantities are vector quantities. So a scalar quantities are those quantities which required magnitude only for their representation. We can say that a scalar quantity is that which has magnitude only. For example, if a person go to a shopkeeper, he says that give me a sugar of 5 kg, where kg is a unit of mass and 5 is a magnitude. Whereas the second group is physical quantity is vector quantity. A vector quantity has magnitude as well as direction. For representation of vector quantities, we need magnitude. Magnitude means quantity and the direction, in which direction it is moved. For example, if you tell to a student that walk 5 meters, so he will not understand you that in which direction I have to walk 5 meters. But if you tell to the similar student that walk 5 meters in forward direction or in backward direction or in right direction or in left direction, so then he will fully understand that in which direction he will be moved in 5 meters. So the main difference between scalar quantity and the vector quantity is that the direction. Both quantities have a magnitude, number, quantity, but vector quantities need a direction and the scalar quantities do not need the direction for their representation. In below table, we have given some physical quantities and differentiate the scalar and vector quantities. So in below table we have three columns. The first column is the name of quantity which is used in physics O level. The second column is that quantity is a scalar, and the third column is that quantity is a vector. So the first quantity which is used in physics is distance. Distance is the scalar quantity. So for representation of distance, we do not need the direction. The next is the displacement. Displacement is a vector quantity. To represent the displacement, we need direction. The third one is length. Length is a scalar quantity. For representation of the length, we do not need the direction. The next one is speed. Speed is a scalar quantity. Like we can see the speed directly from the speed meter of the car or motorcycle or any electronic instrument. Next one is a velocity. Velocity is a vector quantity. For representation or for measuring the velocity, we need the direction. Next one is time. Time is a scalar quantity. Acceleration. Acceleration is a vector quantity. Force. Force is very important quantity in physics, and force is a vector quantity. Next one is a weight. Weight is also a type of force, and it is also a vector quantity. Density. Density is the scalar quantity. It do not depend on the direction. Similarly, area also is the scalar quantity. Volume is also a scalar quantity. Energy, we are taking the energy drinks to boost our energy. So energy is also scalar quantity, is do not need the direction. And pressure is also scalar quantity. So these are some of the example of scalar and vector quantities which are used in physics O level course. I hope you will be fully understand. Next time we will be discuss the representation of vector quantities. Thank you. Best of luck.